Welcome to online class. Now we are going to see Standard 9th English Unit 3 Memory Poem On Killing a Tree. Children, On Killing a Tree is written by G. Patel. It's a very important poem. There is a chance for asking in your third summative assessment. This is a very important poem. So make sure that you are revising this memory poem daily. Okay. Now, first let us start with the motivational quote. The care of earth is our most ancient and most worthy and after all our most pleasing responsibility. Once again I repeat, the care of the earth is our most ancient, most worthy and after all our most pleasing responsibility. Okay, children, before I start this, let me ask you two questions. Okay, children, what is a tree? We all have seen trees here and there, is it? What is the meaning of tree? You will be writing these answers in your classroom notebook. Okay. Your second question, why trees are very important for our survival? Why they are very important for our survival? Okay. Yes, you will write answers for this two questions. Okay. Before I will start this, let us see a brief detail about the poet G. Patel, which is there in the page number 76. G. Patel was born on 18th August 1914. He is a versatile genius, a combination of 4 P, that is poet, playwright, painter and a practicing physician in Mumbai. Actually, children, our poet G. Patel, he is a famous doctor, he is a surgeon. Along with that, he loves to write, he likes to write poems. Yes, Dr. G. Patel is one of the prominent Indian poets. His famous work include Evening, Forensic Medicine and From Bombay Central. He has also penned 3 plays. He has been conducting a poetry workshop in Rishi Valley School for more than a decade. Actually, we all know he is a famous doctor. Along with that, he has a habit of conducting poetry competition in a Rishi Valley School for more than 10 years. Every year he will conduct the poetry competition. He will collect all the poets and then he will make us a book. Yeah, from that particular book only we have taken this On Killing a Tree. This poem is taken from his poetry collection, Poems published in 1966. Okay. Now let us see in detail about this poem. Before I start this poem, let me tell you a introduction about this poem. Actually, children, this poem shows the negative thoughts of the human being. See, this poem paints a vivid and brutal picture of what is involved in killing a tree. So here it shows the brutalness and there is negative character of the human being by cutting a tree. The poem is a graphic picture of man's cruelty and merciless act towards the tree, which symbolizes nature. The poet gives us step-by-step instruction on how to kill a tree and makes us realize that killing a tree is like murdering a human being. In this poem, we'll be seeing step-by-step how killing a tree is compared with the human being, that is murdering a human being. It also refers to the destructive nature of human and nature itself. Okay, now let us see line by line analysis of the poem, which is there in page number 74. Okay. It takes much time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of a knife will do it. It has grown slowly, consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air and water, and out of its leprous hide, sprouting leaves. Once again I repeat, it takes much time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of the knife will do it. It has grown slowly, consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing the years of sunlight, air, water, and out of its leprous hide, sprouting leaves. Here, the poet says that it takes a long time to cut a tree. It is not actually, how many, do you know that how many years a plant has to become a tree, how many years it takes? Do you know that? It takes many years, is it? It takes many years by consuming our earth, consuming our soil's fertility, and then it takes our air, it takes sunlight, then air, everything. After consuming everything, only the trees grows into very big in creature. So such a big tree, it is not easy for a human being to use a knife to cut the tree, is it? Is it? So see here, it takes much time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of the tree. Jab in the sense to poke or thrust abruptly with a short, quick blow. With a simple blow, with a quick blow, we cannot cut that big tree which has consumed many years of soil fertility, which has consumed many years of air, which has consumed the sunlight, which has consumed the water. So such a big tree, it is not very easy for a human being to give a quick blow. With a small blow, we cannot cut that tree. Then, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air, water, and out of its leprous hide, sprouting leaves. So next, it has grown up by consuming the earth slowly. It grew up and rise from the crust of the earth, which has grew up. The tree has come out from the crust of the earth, absorbing years of sunlight, water, and from its these discolored and uneven bark, the branches and leaves sprout out. So from, actually you have seen the bark of the tree, is it? It is somewhat like brownish color, discolored, okay? From that we get a tree. So it is not easy for a human being to cut such a big tree with a simple jab, with a simple quick blow. So let's see how, let's see what he is going to say in the next stanza. So, hack and chop, but this alone won't do it. Not such much pain will do it. The bleeding bark will heal, and from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs, miniature boughs, which if unchecked will expand again to former size. Once again I repeat, to hack and chop, but this alone won't do it. Not so much pain will do it. The bleeding bark will heal, and from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs, miniature boughs, which if unchecked will expand again to former size. See how beautifully he has said that. See, to hack and chop, but this alone won't do it. If I just cut, hack and cut, that is cutting roughly the tree by striking using the knife, is not enough for the tree. What will happen if you cut the branches? If we go and you see next month, again it will go into such a big tree. Whatever pain, whatever distraction human beings give to trees, they are ready to survive. They are saying that I will come back. Is it? So here, whatever they do, however they cut, they hack and chop the tree, they are saying that I will come back. So this is alone won't do it. Not so much pain will do it. The bleeding bark will heal. When we cut the tree, there is a bleeding bark. It is like a gum will come out, is it? That also will heal. Heal means in the sense it will get chopped off. Again, it will grow into a tree. So, and from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs. Okay, anything that is heavy blows and chopping, anything to enamorous tree. It is not a pain, and its bleeding bark will heal soon. Actually, when we cut the tree, what happens? Again, it will grow up, is it? So that is what he is saying. So only a simple one with a hack and chop, the trees will not get chopped. Once again, it will grow up, the branches will come out. See here, will rise curled green twigs. That is, once again, the branches will come out. That is mini branches, that is what? Miniature boughs. Miniature means very small. Once again, very small branches come out. If unchecked, will expand again to the former size. What is the second stanza it is saying? Even though if we cut and chop the branch, that is cut and chop the tree, after a minimum time, after a respective time. If you go and see the tree once again, small branches, the twigs, curling twigs, and then everything might have come back again. Again, there is a chance for the tree. Again, there is a chance for the tree to come back into its original size. So, what is saying? See, no, the root is to be pulled out. One of the anchoring earth. It is to be roped, tied, and pulled out, snapped out, or pulled out entirely. No, the root is to be pulled out. One of the anchoring earth. It is to be roped, tied, and pulled out, snapped out, or pulled out entirely out of the earth cave, and the strength of the tree exposed, the source white and wet, the most sensitive hidden for years inside the earth. So in the first two stanza, in the first stanza it says that a simple jab, a simple quick blow will not hurt the tree anything. So the second, in the second stanza it says, even though you chop and hack the tree, when you see after a particular time, again it will come back to its former size. In the third stanza it is saying that, he is starting with the quotation no. Why the poet says no is in the beginning of the stanza? Why? Because just a small cut or chop will not harm the tree. This will not harm the tree. It has a capacity to come back again. So in this stanza, what the poet wants to tell us is, for killing a tree, first, what you have, all these people are doing it. For killing a tree, what these people are doing it? Even though they, see, they hear actually many here and there because of this big companies, we all know. Further, they have occupied lands. So then they have to lay roads. For that, they have destroyed many trees. What they are doing it? They will not cut. They will pull it from the earth itself. So here he is comparing that pulling the, they are tying the trees, is it? And then they are pulling from the earth crust. He is comparing it to the human beings. That is comparing to the human being. How the actually, how the mother, she nurtures his baby. Is it? After a particular time only, the baby comes out from mother and in the same place. If it comes in before itself, what will happen? It will harm the baby. In the same way, see here, for killing a tree, firstly, the root has to be pulled out from its earth. So here he is comparing to the mother. There is actually, here it is comparing to the mother, nurtures the baby and protects her baby and gives and send her to the safe place. Okay, in some way, earth also protects the root of the tree, is it? We are not able to see the roots. Roots are hidden under the earth's crust. So it is protected by the earth. What these human beings are doing it? They are tying it. Is it? See, they have written, how nicely has written. Roped, tied and pulled out and snagged out of the earth. So it is pulled out of the earth. Okay, when the roots are seen to the sunlight, when it is exposed to the sunlight, then the tree will not come back again. Is it? Is it a good thing what the human being is doing with the trees? We have done, actually, trees, it helps us in many ways. Without trees, we cannot survive. Is it? So that capacity trees has. So like such tree, if we are going on cutting trees for our benefits, what will the earth happens? You just imagine and see it, children. See it. Then, it may a victory to human being. That is, by cutting a tree, by pulling the tree out of the earth, at crust, it may be a victory to human being, but it will lead to global warming. Is it? If we go on cut a tree, just imagine. Just imagine yourself, you are standing in a place where there is no tree. Then how you will behave? Is it possible when the person goes to the moon, what is the costume he wears? Because there is no oxygen, there is no trees, there, people cannot survive. So they will wear all these costumes and go. Is it possible to survive in earth? Or is it possible? So trees are very important, at least in our lifetime it's at least one plant we might have planted. Okay? See, in next stanza what he is saying? Then the matter of scorching and choking in the sun and air, browning, hardening, twisting, writhing, and when it is done. See here. Then actually here once it is extracted from the earth, once the trees come out of the earth, the human put the tree in a extreme torture. It is the extreme torture we are doing it, is it? First we have cut, jab the tree, again we have chop and hack the tree, again tying it, pulling it out of the earth crust. It is the extreme torture we are giving it, which is helping us in all ways. Without first and main thing, without oxygen we cannot survive, which is given only by the trees. Imagine if there is no trees and only animals are around us, what will be our situation? So this greenery nature is needed for us. If we go on cut the greenery nature for our benefits, what will happen to our earth? Just imagine and see. So it's an extreme torture what we are giving to the trees. In the last stanza, see what the author is saying. Then the matter of scorching and choking. Scorching in the sense of choking. So when trees come out, we are giving an extreme torture to the trees. When it is come, when it comes out of the tree because of the hot sun, choking in the sense prevent from growing. That's all. It cannot come back again. Is it? Once the tree is pulled out of the earth crust, it will not come again. So there is no chance for the tree to see once again, which has survived for many years. It might have seen our grandparents, grand-grandparents also. So such trees we are pulling out, such beautiful trees, such helpful trees we are pulling out of the earth. And we are throwing the roots in the sun, air, and which gets browning, hardening, twisting, withering in the sense, finally shed off its skin under different weather condition, and then it is dead. Then the tree is killed. So this is the human being which is doing with the tree. They are doing with the tree in killing the tree, on killing the tree. So this is the poem. I hope you have understood. Here our poet indirectly says, it is directly indirectly says that to not to cut the trees. Actually what he wants to say in the sense, this careless attitude of cutting trees will definitely lead us to the bad future, is it? Imagine yourself that if we cannot survive without trees, so it's a bad thing, bad attitude which a human is showing towards a tree. Nearly, children, you know that nearly 100,000 acres of forest are cleared per day. Trees have to live, only then we will get oxygen. Otherwise, human would not be able to survive on the earth. Is that correct, Pangino? If trees are not there, human will not be able to survive. Already, if we are in a pandemic situation because of this virus. Imagine if we go on cut the trees, what will happen to our earth? What is the gift we are going to our future? It will be a big question mark. So, at least for your lifetime, in your life, try to plant a tree. Yes. Now let us, this is very important poem. Make sure that you are preparing this memory poem. Okay, now let us see about the question answers, which is there in page number 76. Okay, children. So we have seen the memory poem. Now let us see the book exercise, which is there in page number 76. First, let us start with the synonyms. Synonyms is very important so that you will understand the concept of the poem easily. Jab. To poke or thrust abruptly with a short quick blow. Jab, one quick blow on the tree. Thrust, the brown hard outer portion of the earth surface. Is it? That is called as the crust. Leprous, cover with the scales, hide the strong thick outer skin. Bark will say nama, that is nothing but the leprous. Then miniature, very small. Miniature means very small. In art work they do miniature painting, they say. Miniature means very small and minute painting. Okay. Now let us see in detail about the question answers. Anyhow, children, I'll send the question answers through PDF. Make sure that you are writing with your neat handwriting by date, lesson name. Okay, everything as usual how the people do. Sincerely you write everything. Starting with the dictation words. Okay. So with your neat handwriting, you will submit the classwork in your office room. But anyhow, I just dictate. Okay. It takes much time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of the tree will do it. Can a simple jab of the tree kill a tree? Is it easy a tree to kill with a simple jab, simple quick blow? Answer is no. Why does it take much time to kill a tree? It takes much time to kill a tree as it is grown strong Second question. It has grown, slowly consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing. How has the tree grown? The tree has grown slowly, consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust. That is the from the point we can take. Isn't it? It has grown slowly, consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing. So how it has grown? By consuming the earth. Next, what does the tree feed from the crust? The tree feeds sunlight and water from the crust. From the earth surface, it has absorbed the sunlight and then air and then water. Is it? From the earth's crust. Okay. The third question. And out of its leprous hide, sprouting leaves. What does the phrase leprous hide mean? Leprous hide means discolored bark. Bark is in the outer skin of the tree. Of the tree. Next, what comes out of the leprous hide? Sprouting leaves come out of the leprous. That is leaves. Leaves sprout from the bark, from the branch of the tree. The fourth question. The bleeding bark will heal and from close to the ground will rise curled green twigs, miniature boughs. What will happen with the bleeding bark? When we cut a tree, there is a bleeding from the bark, is it? So what will happen? It will heal up. It will get healed up. So the bleeding bark will heal. Then next question. What will rise from close to the ground? Curled green twigs and miniature boughs. Boughs in the sense, miniature small branches will rise from close to the ground. Even though we cut the tree, they cut not completely using that axe. Even though if we cut the tree, there is a chance for the tree to come out. Is it? The twigs and branches will come out. Okay. Next question. The root is to be pulled out, one of the anchoring earth. Why should the root be pulled out? The root should be pulled out to kill the tree. What does anchoring earth mean? Anchoring earth means that the roots fixed to the earth strongly like an anchor. Okay, it is fixed to the root strongly. Actually, I told you how the mother nurtures the baby in the same earth is taking care of this roots. What these human beings are doing, cruelly behaving mercilessly, pulling out of the root from the earth itself. Is it? Yes. Okay, children, now let us see the based on the understanding of the poem, write down the summary of the poem by filling the blanks. I'm going on dictating it, you'll be filling this answers in your textbook. The poet explains the process of killing a tree. A lot of work has to be done in order to root it out completely. It cannot be accomplished by merely cutting it with a knife. The tree has grown strong with the help of sunlight, water and nutrients of the soil by absorbing nutrients of the soil for the countless years. Even the bark of the tree gives rise to the leaves. The boughs sprout new twigs and leaves. In short period, they grow into a new tree. So, to kill it completely, one should take out roots completely from the soil. Then they should be exposed to the sunlight and heat. Only then the tree will be completely killed. This is summary of this poem. Okay, then next let us deal with the question answers. What is the poem about? So, this poem is about killing a tree. So, this directly is saying that not to kill a tree. Then, what are the lessons to be learned from the poem? The poem teaches us about the nature and sturdiness and longevity of the tree. To kill the tree or anything else, the heart of the thing has to be destroyed. What are the life sources needed for a tree to grow? Soil, water, oxygen and then air. Okay. What does the poet mean by bleeding bark? The cutting into a bark whose snap. The poet compares the fluid to the blood. Next question. Why does the poet say no in the beginning of the third stanza? So in the third stanza it starts with the beginning no. Why? He wants to emphasize emphasize that it is not easy to kill a tree. It is not easy because even though if we give a small jab and chop and hack, there is a chance for the tree to come back once again. It is not an easy job. So what is human being? A human being are more merciless than the tree, is it? They are pulling out its roots from the earth crust.